And here is the Writer's Almanac for Friday, December the 11th, 2020. It's the birthday of Grace Paley, born in New York City in 1922, grew up in the Bronx, surrounded by all sorts of immigrants. Her own parents spoke Yiddish and Russian at home, English only in public. She loved to hear all these different tongues. But when she started writing poetry, she wrote in a formal, stilted British style. She thought that's what poems were supposed to sound like. And then she met W.H. Auden, and he read her work. And Grace Paley recalled, "We went through a few poems, and he kept asking me, 'Do you really talk like that?' And I kept saying, 'Oh, well, sometimes.' That was the great thing I learned from Auden, that you'd better talk your own language." It's the birthday of the novelist Thomas McGuane, Wyandotte, Michigan, 1939. Came from a family of Irish Catholics, emigrated to Massachusetts, where they saw themselves as outsiders. He said, "My parents moved to the Midwest. I can assure you that whatever we thought we were, we did not consider ourselves to be Midwesterners. When I moved to Montana in my 20s, I felt myself to be an outsider. The only thing that seems reassuring is that most Montanans feel the same way." McGuane went to the University of Michigan. One of his classmates was Jim Harrison. They became lifelong friends. First novel, The Sporting Club, 1969. He sold the film rights and bought a ranch with the profits. Spent the 70s in Hollywood writing screenplays, Rancho Deluxe, The Missouri Breaks. McGuane said, "Aspiring to be a screenwriter is like aspiring to be a co-pilot." Thomas McGuane, fly fisherman. He was Montana's cutting horse champion for 3 years in a row. It's the birthday of Jim Harrison, Grayling, Michigan, 1937. He was a poet who went out hunting with his dog, fell off a cliff, hurt his back, had to stay in bed for months, and then turned to writing fiction as a way to pass the time. The book was Wolf, a False Memoir. Went on to write Legends of the Fall, The Farmer's Daughter, and The Big Seven. Here's a poem by Jim Harrison entitled Bridge. "Most of my life was spent building a bridge out over the sea, though the sea was too wide. I'm proud of the bridge, hanging in the pure sea air. Machado came for a visit, and we sat on the end of the bridge, which was his idea. Now that I'm old, the work goes slowly, ever nearer death. I like it out here, high above the sea, bundled up for the Arctic storms of late fall, the resounding crash and moan of the sea, the 100-foot depth of the green troughs. Sometimes the sea roars and howls like the animal it is, a continent wide and alive. What beauty in this, the darkest music over which you can hear the lightest music of human behavior, the tender connection between men and galaxies. So I sit on the edge, wagging my feet above the abyss. Tonight the moon will be in my lap. This is my job, to study the universe from my bridge. I have the sky, the sea, the faint green streak of Canadian forest on the far shore." A poem by Jim Harrison, Bridge, from Dead Man's Float, published by Copper Canyon Press and used by permission here on the Writer's Almanac, funded by donations from listeners like you, now available on PRX for distribution by your local radio station. Be well, do good work, and keep in touch.
The Life Story of a Shy Midwesterner, Garrison Keillor's new memoir, That Time of Year, A Minnesota Life, is available now in hardcover and ebook at garrisonkeillor.com and at Amazon.